don't think you have anything to worry about, Charlie Brown.
The only thing wrong with my big brother
is
I think how beautiful it is and how my life lies before me. And I get a very positive feeling about things. Like this morning, for instance. The sky is so clear and the sun's so bright. How could anything go wrong on a day like this? I'm late!
Memorize that phrase by heart.
And you were born for this part,
so tell me
you're a good man.
I need to know.
We
think lunchtime is about the worst time of day for me. Always having to sit here, alone. Of course, mornings aren't so pleasant either. Waking up and wondering if anyone would really miss me if I ever got out of bed. Well, there's also nights, too. Lying there and thinking about all the stupid things I did during the day. And all those hours in between when I do those stupid things. Well, lunchtime is among the worst times of day for me. I guess I better see what I got. Peanut butter again. Some psychiatrists say that people who eat peanut butter sandwiches are lonely. I guess they were right. And when you're really lonely, your peanut butter sticks to the roof of your mouth. Boy, the PTA sure did a good job of painting these benches. There's that cute little red-haired girl eating her lunch. I wonder what she would do if I walked over there and asked to sit by her. She'd probably laugh right in my face. It's hard on a face when it gets laughed in. There's a spot right next to her. I don't know why I couldn't just walk over there and sit there. I could do that right now. All I have to do is stand up. I'm standing up. I am sitting down. I'm a coward. I'm so much of a coward that she wouldn't even think to look at me. She hardly ever does look at me. In fact, I can't even remember one time that she ever looked at me. Is there any reason in the world why she shouldn't look at me? Is she so great and I'm so small that she can't spare one little moment? She's looking at me.
No, Charlotte, you're thinking of the other dress, the one I wore to Lisina's party. The one I'm talking about is the very light blue one with the embroidered waist.
I don't remember.
Something like this. The skirt went out like this. It had these puffy sleeves and a sash like this.
Oh, yes, I remember.
Yes, well, that was the dress I was wearing last week when I met Frida.
Lunchtime is among the worst times of day for me. If that little red-haired girl was looking at me with a stupid bag over my head, she'd think I was the biggest fool alive. But if she isn't looking at me, then maybe I could take the bag off really quick and she didn't even notice. But on the other hand, I can't tell if she's looking at me or not until I take the bag off. But then again, if I never take the bag off, I'll never know if she's looking at me or not. But on the other hand, it's getting very hard to breathe in here. She's not looking at me. She's not even here. I wonder why she never looks at me. Oh well, one lunch hour over with, only 2,863 to go.
Wouldn't you like that if someday we'd try to discuss marriage with a musician.
Happiness is a fleeting thing, Sally, and I think that a man can come closer to it by directing the forces of his life to a single goal that he believes in. And I think that a man's personal search for happiness is not really a selfish thing either, because achieving happiness himself, he can help others find it. Does that make sense to you?
We had spaghetti at our house 3 times this week.
You know, like a princess sort of thing, with a nice dress and pretty slippers and a big ballroom. But I guess that sounds kind of silly, doesn't it, Charlie Brown?
Oh, no, not at all. I mean, we all have our little daydreams or ambitions or whatever you want to call them. Like, I've had one for myself, but thing is, I've never told anybody.
What? You could tell me.
Oh, no, it's not the thing I should talk about. No, I don't think I should, no.
Come on, please.
No, it's not the thing I should really talk about. It'd be bad if I told you.
Pretty please with the cherry on top.
Okay. I've always wanted to be called Flash. I hate the name Charlie. I would be so good at everything and so athletic that everyone would call me Flash. I want everyone to know me and that everyone will call me Flash.
Hey, Frida, listen to this one.
Oh. Patty?
I don't know. I was jumping rope. Everything was fine. Then suddenly it all seemed so futile.
Beethoven used to be fond of taking long walks in the country. He was always inspired by the beautiful sound of the countryside. Had it nice.
On your doghouse, and I'll be out later with your supper.
I think Snoopy's such a wonderful dog.
Me too. He's just about the best dog there is.
You're holding my hand, Chuck. You sly dog, you.
Oh!
They like me. I think they're swell. Isn't it remarkable how things turn out so well. Pleasant day, pretty sky, life goes on. Here I fly, not bad. Stomach with the sharp little claws, which
which are usually cold, like occasionally painful, and sometimes there's so many that I can hardly stand it. I know every now and then what I wanna be. A fish, jungle animal, crouched on the limb of a tree. La 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 la. I'd stay very, very still till I see a victim come. I know very, very well every second counts. And then, like the fish, jungle creature I am, I would pounce. I'd pounce. You know, I never realized it was so far away from the ground from up here. Oh! Let me see. Where was I? Oh, that's me. The pretty sky. Not bad. Not bad at all. Home, board and bed, sturdy roof beneath my head. Not bad, not bad at all. Not bad, not bad at all. A wonderful little snow tonight.
I think I'll walk up to that little red-haired girl and introduce myself. Yeah, I think I'll introduce myself and then I'll ask to sit by her. And while we're sitting, I'll tell her how much I've always admired her. And then, I think I'll flap my arms and fly to the moon. You know, today I'm a dog, and yesterday I was a dog too, and tomorrow I'll probably still be a dog. There's just a little hope of advancement.
Today's April Fool's Day, Charlie Brown. I think I'll play a little trick on you. I think I'll try a little trick.
You understand what I'm saying, don't you? You understand that today is April Fool's Day. I want to make sure you understand. Okay.
Hey, Charlie Brown, little redheaded girl up there wants to give you a hug and a kiss.
Oh, really? Well, this is fantastic.
April Fool's. Just like shooting a fish in a barrel.
We'll throw the stick, and you, the dog, will retrieve it.
I, the dog, could not be less interested.
I got it! I got it!
Hello, and welcome to the 25th annual blanket chase of the day. I'm here with my co-host. What's dog? What do you have to say about this blanket chase?
Come and get it, little baby!
Yes, indeed. Looks like Lucia's forehead. Oh, now Linus is catching up, and it looks like they are now engaged in a serious game of tug of war, ladies and gentlemen.
You give me my blanket back!
No, I've got it, and I'm gonna keep it! This is just the start you need to break your disgusting little habit!
Well, apparently, you haven't read the latest scientific reports. A blanket is as important to a child as a hobby to an adult. And any man spends his time restoring antique automobiles, or building marble trains, or collecting old telephones, or even studying about the Civil War. This is called playing with the past!
Really?
Certainly. This is good for these men to cope with their everyday problems. But I feel it's going to be absolutely necessary for me to get my blanket back. So I'm just going to give it a good yank.
What do you have to say about your victory today, Linus?
It's surprising what you can accomplish with a little smooth talking. It's a fast action. It's almost out of blanket. It's like in a cone without ice cream. My blanket and me. What do you mean? It's a cold sanctuary, but it's far from necessary, cause I'm just as self-reliant as before. As a simple demonstration of my independent nation, I will go and leave my blanket on the floor. Yes, I'll walk away and leave it, though I know you won't believe it. I'll just walk away and leave it on the floor. La 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 la.
Some television.
Yes, I will buy myself a queen.
I can't hear you!
Aye, aye, Captain!
Oh.
Now, switch channels.
Are you kidding? I'm not one of your royal subjects. What makes you can come in here and take over?
These five fingers, individually, they're nothing when I curl them together into a single unit. They become a fighting force, terrible to behold.
Yes, Your Majesty. Why can't you guys get organized like that?
Circuses and roller skates and bracelets?
You never mentioned jump ropes.
Are you mad at jump ropes?
I'm especially mad at stupid jump ropes!
This is for you, Lucy. Happy Valentine's Day. No, that doesn't sound right. This is for you, Lucy. Happy Valentine's Day. No, you can do it if you just don't get nervous. That's for you, Lucy. Happy Valentine's Day. No, you can do it. Just. This is for you, Lucy. Merry Christmas. Oh! I'd do anything if that little red-haired girl sent me a Valentine. Wait, maybe she did send me one. Yeah, maybe she did send me one, and it's in her mailbox right now. Oh, I'm afraid to look. If I open it and nothing's in there, I'll be crushed. But if she did send me one, I've gotta look. Hello! Nothing echoes like an empty mailbox.
I've been thinking about why you didn't get any Valentines, Big Brother. I think I figured it out. You didn't get any Valentines because no one sent you any!
I can't stand it. Look at all of them laughing and enjoying their Valentines. I sent a Valentine to everyone I know this Valentine's Day, and did I get any in return? No, not one. I didn't get one stupid Valentine. I get about as many Valentines as a dog.
Red-headed girl.
My stomach hurts. Oh, Lucy, I'm so depressed. Everything is going wrong, and I don't know what to do.
I'm so sorry to hear that, Charlie Brown. Maybe there's something I can do to help. I think what you need, most of all, is to come right out and admit all the things that are wrong with you.
You really think that'll help?
Certainly.
All right. I'll try. I'm not very handsome or clever or lucid. I've always been stupid at spelling and numbers. I've never been much playing football or baseball or stickball or checkers or marbles or ping pong. I'm usually awful at parties and dances. I stand like a stick or I cough or I laugh or I don't bring a present or I spill the ice cream or I get so depressed that I stand in ice cream. Oh, how could there possibly be one small person as thoroughly, totally, utterly, as me?
Well, that's okay for a start.
A starter?
Well, sure. You don't think that mentioning these few superficial failings are gonna do you any good, do you? Well, Charlie Brown, you really have to tell. You're stupid, self-centered, and moody.
I'm moody.
You're terribly dull to be with.
Yes, I am. And nobody likes me, not Frida, or Shermie, or Linus, or Schroeder.
Or Lucy.
Or Lucy.
Or Snoopy.
Or Snoop. Wait a minute, Snoopy likes me.
He only pretends to like you because you feed him. That doesn't count.
Poor Snoopy. Oh, why was I just born to be one small person is thoroughly, totally, utterly.
Wait! You're not very much of a person.
That's certain.
Yet there is reason for hope.
There's hope?
Although you are no good at music like Schroeder, you are happy like Snoopy, or lovely like me. You have the distinction to be no one else but the single, remarkable, unique Charlie Brown.
I'm me! Gosh, Lucy, you know what? I've been feeling better already. You're a true friend, Lucy. A true friend.
That'll be 5 cents, please.
I couldn't decide if I wanted fudge marble, chocolate, vanilla, or Rocky Road. I finally chose fudge marble. Then I decided if I wanted a plain cone or a sugar cone. I choose the sugar cone. So what happens? I walk outside and I drop the whole thing on the sidewalk. Don't tell me my life isn't a Shakespearean tragedy.
Today's my grandfather's birthday, Rerun.
How old is he?
63. It's hard to believe he was once a human being.
Hey, Violet, do you want some jelly beans?
Sure, what kind?
A red one, and I think this is a green one.
Ew! Disgusting! Gross! And...
what's got into her?
This day has been bad enough for me. But maybe if I'm lucky, tomorrow will be a better day.
Well, in some parts of the world, tomorrow is already today, and today is yesterday. So if tomorrow is already today, Chuck, there's no way that tomorrow could possibly be a better day.
You're a lot of fun to have around. You know, why is it I always have my supper in the red dish and my drinking water in the yellow dish? Oh, one of these days, I'm gonna have my drinking water in the red dish, oh, my supper in the yellow dish. You know, life's just too short. You gotta live it up a little.
Marcy, I wish I had a secret admirer. Someone who would send me flowers and little love notes and things like that. And then all of a sudden, he'll tell me who he loves.
Then you would need another secret admirer.
Penny, for your thoughts, Frida.
I was just thinking, wouldn't it be wonderful to have your whole life to live over if you know what you know now?
What do I know now?
Probably very little, Violet, which isn't the case for me. For instance, I know being born beautiful carries an awesome weight of responsibility.
True.
Isn't anybody curious to know what I know now?
I wouldn't say curious. Obligated is more like it. Well, go ahead, Patty.
I know now that you can't bend a cracker. No matter how hard you try,
you may try.
I know now that your body isn't leaking when you cry.
When you cry.
I know now that a smile with a lousy umbrella.
Try to sing a cappella.
Over.
is art, you blockhead. This is great music I'm playing, and great music is an art. Do you hear me? An art, art, art!
You fascinate me.
World War I, flying ace high over France in his Southwest Camel, searching for the infamous Red Baron. I must bring him down. Suddenly, anti-aircraft fire,
Archie we used to call it,
begins to burst beneath my plane. The Red Baron has spotted me.
Na 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 na, you can't hit me. Actually, tough flying is never saying na na na. I was just playing around.
Oh, you're at this fog. It's bad enough having to fight the Red Baron to have to fly in weather like this. All right, Red Baron, where are you? You can't hide from me forever! Ah, the sun has broken through! I can see the woods of Mondstadt below! Ça va? Bonjour!
Wait a minute.
What's that? It's a fliegen, floggen, track plane! The Red Baron! Ha! I've got you this time!
Wait a minute.
He's diving down to the sun! He's tricked me! I can't see him! I've got to run! Come on, Zobus Kimmel! Let's go! Go, Kimmel! Go, go, go! I can't shake him! He's riddling my plane with bullets! Oh no! This is not good! Curse you, Red Baron! Curse you and your kind! Oh! Curse you and all the evil that causes this unhappiness! Here's the World War I flying ace back at the aerodrome in France. He is exhausted, yet he does not sleep, for one thought burns in his mind. Someday, I will get you, Red Baron!
Why are you telling me?
Why are you telling me? I like it! That's a good philosophy. Why are you telling me? 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 My new philosophy. That teacher gave an E on last week's homework. She said, Miss Sally Brown, your grades are going down. I could have told her.
Your new philosophy.
My new philosophy. Miss B, I'm she. Look, C, a D, a D. Well, why are you telling me? And that's my new philosophy.
That's your new philosophy.
Why are you telling me? My new philosophy, yeah!
That's great, Sal, but I have to go practice Chopin's Nocturne in B flat minor.
No! I like it! No! That's a good philosophy! No! 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 No!
That's your new philosophy, huh?
Yes! I mean, no. Just like your busy bee, each new philosophy can fly from tree to tree and keep me moving.
Whoa!
When life's a dizzy maze on alternating days, I choose a different phrase.
Your new philosophy.
My new philosophy.
Sally! are simple. Man does not live by bread alone. Some philosophies are clear.
Leave your message at the sound of the town.
Some philosophies we can choose. Deciding what goes in it. Something to look towards. But Sally, anything that only takes a minute can't be very lasting. For instance, Beethoven took over 2 years to complete his brilliant ninth symphony.
No!
I can't stand it!
I can't stand it! I like it! It's like a guarantee, my new philosophy. And things are sure to be a whole lot brighter. Oh yeah, that's what you think. Why are you telling me? No, I can't stand it! Now life is free and easy. Much more philosophy than always. My brand new. You know, someone has said that we should live each day as if it were the last day of our lives.
This is the last!
I want this to be our biggest and best game of the season. If you all would just bear down and grit our teeth, then...
Charlie Brown, I thought up some new strategy for you. Why don't you tell the other team that we're going to play them at a certain place? Only it's not the real place, see? And when they don't show up, we'll win by forfeit. Isn't that good strategy? I don't understand these managers don't want to use good strategy!
So, yeah, if we all just bear down and grit our teeth, then...
That other team was trash-talking us, Chad Van, but I got even with them, though. I said, hey, you think you're so great? Mozart started writing symphonies when he was your age. That really shut him up.
I bet it did. So, yeah, if we just bear down and grit our teeth, then I'm sure we could finish the season.
Perhaps you shouldn't be a playing manager, Charlie Brown. Perhaps you should be a bench manager.
Ooh, that's a good idea! You'd be a great bench manager, Big Brother! You could say, bench do this, or bench do that. You could even be in charge of where we put the bench. When we get to the playing field, you can say, let's put the bench here, or let's put the bench there.
I can't stand it!
What's the point of us playing when we know we're going to lose anyways? Even if there was a million to one chance we might win, it would make some sense.
Well, there may not be a million to one chance, but I'm sure there's at least a billion to one chance.
Yeah,
now, come on! Give me a T!
T!
Give me an E!
E!
Give me an A!
A!
Give me an M!
M!
What do you got?
T! There's
no T like the best.
Schroeder was catcher and all of the team was the same as always, but somehow a rather disaster struck at the baseball game.
Hello!
Hello! Alright, heads and heads and ready and great! Dropped it. I don't think that's good for our team's morale to see their out by fighting a runner and catching the ball in his teeth. Linus caught flies from Earth Dory window by holding his blanket beneath. Yes, we had 4-2, but we can't argue with that. And one run went with us the games I came up to bat.
All right, Chem, we're all behind
like
you.
Like the best, sort of.
I mean, this man can't pitch. He pitches like my grandmother.
We will show you.
Now, all you have to do is bear down. Just bear down. Listen, when you get to first, watch me for the signal. Got it, Flash?
With the big baseball sign. For all we have to do is win one more game.
And the championship is ours.
Two men were on with two outs and me with one strike.
One strike.
To
one strike.
Go.
One strike.
Then I saw her, this cute little red-headed girl. I know. Firmly I vowed I would win it for her. And I shouldered my bat and I swung.
Person. I know your crabbiness has probably come so natural that you're not even aware that you're being crabby. Just the same.
You're a very crabby person, Lucy, and I hope you take it into spirit that it is intended. I think Socrates was right when he said the number one rule of life was to know thyself.
Well, I guess I said enough. I hope I didn't offend you or anything.
What's Socrates got to do with it anyway, huh? Who was she anyway? Did she ever get to be queen? Tell me that. Did she ever get to be queen? Did she ever get to be queen? Well, who was Socrates anyway? Know thyself, huh?
That was the worst game ever. But get the glove, Snoopy. Go get the glove. Get the glove. All right, now, you want to help me get my throwing arm back into shape? Now watch out for this one. It's a new fastball.
Excuse me a moment, Charlie Brown, but I was wondering if you'd mind answering a few questions.
Certainly, Lucy.
Well, I'm conducting a survey to enable me to know myself better. And first of all, I'd like to ask, on a scale of 0 to 100, using a standard of 50 as average, 75 as above average, and 90 as exceptional, where would you rate me with regards to crabbiness?
Well,
your ballots need not be signed until all answers will be held in strictest confidence.
But still, Lucy, that's a very difficult question to answer.
Fine. This next question deals with certain character traits that you may have observed. Regarding personality, would you say that mine was A, forceful, B, pleasing, or C, objectionable? Would that be A, B, or C? What would your answer be to that, Charlie Brown? A, B, or C?
Charlie
Brown.
I'd have to say forceful, Lucy, but...
Forceful. Well, we'll make a check mark at the letter A, then. This next question deals with physical appearance in referring to my beauty. Which is that I was stunning, mysterious, or intoxicating.
Lucy. I don't know. You look just fine to me.
Stunning. All right, Charlie Brown, I think we should get back to that first question. On a scale of 0 to 100, using a standard of 50 as average, 75 as
I
above.
Remember the question, Lucy.
Well.
51?
51 is your crabbiness rating for me. Yay. This next question. Oh, that about does it, I think. Thank you very much for your cooperation. It's been greatly appreciated.
It was a pleasure, Lucy. Come on, Snoopy.
Oh, wait, there is one more question. On a scale, would you answer yes or no to this question? Is Lucy Van Pelt the sort of person that you would like to have a president of your club or civic organization?
Why, yes, by all means.
Well, that about does it, I think. Thank you very much.
Yeah, let's see that.
What was you?
Okay. It's 51, 11. Roy and Frieda are right. I can already feel myself being filled with glow of self-awareness.
C, poor, none of the above, no! And what are you going to do about that dent you made in my bicycle?
It's amazing how fast the word of these surveys gets around.
Oh, Linus, I'm conducting a survey and I wonder if you'd mind answering a few questions.
Sure, go ahead.
Well, first question is, on a scale of 0 to 100, using a standard of 50 as average, 75 as above average, and 90 as exceptional, where would you rate me with regards to crabbiness?
Ha! You're my big sister!
That's not the question.
No, but that's the answer.
I promise not to slug you, Linus. Now, what number would you give me as your crabbiness rating?
95. Ouch.
There. It's all done. Now, let's see what we've got. Crabby person. I'm a very crabby person and everybody knows it. I've done nothing but spread crabbiness everywhere I go. I'm a super crab. It's a wonder anyone will still talk to me. It's a wonder I have any friends at all or even associates. I've done nothing but breed unhappiness and resentment wherever I go. Where did I go wrong? How could I be so selfish? I'm no good and there's no reason at all I should go on living on the face of this earth.
Yes, there is.
Name one reason why you go on living on this planet.
Well, for once, you have a little brother who loves you. Every now and then, I have to say the right things.
Has a chain of commands. And do you know who the lowest one on that chain is?
Guess. It's the dog. The dog is the lowest one on that chain.
Do you understand?
I said, do you understand?
No, they just hate it when you stare at them like that. Stomach claw just went off. It's supper time. Charlie Brown has forgotten to feed me. Yeah. Here I lie, a withering, hollow shell of dog. And there sits my supper dish. Empty! But that's okay. He'll remember. Yeah. When no furry friend comes to greet him after school, then he'll remember and he'll rush out here to the doghouse, but it'll be too late. There'll be nothing left but the dried carcass. Former friend, used to love to run and play so happily with him. Nothing but the bleached puppy bones of the dog that loved him so.
Hey, Snoopy, are you asleep or something? I've been standing here a whole minute with your supper.
Supper time? Supper time?
Brimming full of meat and meal, which is brought forth to ease our hunger. Behold the flowing flagon moist and sweet, which has been sent to slake
are third.
Okay, there's no need for a big production. Just get down off that doghouse and eat. You think you were in like a musical or something.
The bacon and fill me up, cause it's supper, 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 supper time.
Ba-ya-ba-doo-ba, ba-ya-ba-doo-ba-doo-ba, supper time. Ugh. The dog food, bring on the bone, bring on the barrel and roll me home, cause it's supper, 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 super pepper upper, supper, super duper supper time. Winter time's nice with the ice and snow, summertime's nice with a place to go, bedtime, overtime, halftime too, but they just can't hold the candle to my supper time. Oh yeah! Hello, home listeners. How are ya? Do 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 do. Yeah yeah yeah. Bring on the hamburger. Bring on the bun. Papi's little puppy loves everyone, cause it's supper, 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 supper. Super pepper upper. Super duper supper time.
Supper time.
Woo!
Supper time.
Oh yeah!
Supper time.
Bring on the meat.
Supper time.
Tommy.
Supper time.
Oh.
Something to chew, give me food, give me water, give me something to do.
Now cut that Ooh! Out! Now why can't you eat your food quietly and calmly like any other normal dog?
What's wrong with making mealtime a joyous occasion?
Good grief.
Supper, 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 supper.
Charlie Brown. She says that she's responsible for the education of her little brother, so she's teaching me. Boy, is she intelligent.
Come along, Linus!
Do you see this tree? It is a fir tree. It's called a fir tree because it gives us fur
for coats.
It also gives us wool in the wintertime.
I never knew that before, Lucy. That's really interesting.
And that tree there, it's called an elm tree. Up into a giant tree, and oh, you can tell how old it is by counting its leaves.
Gosh, Lucy, that's fascinating.
Wait a minute, Lucy, I don't mean to interfere, but...
And way up there, those fluffy little white things, those are clouds. They make the wind blow, and way down there, those tiny little black things, those are bugs. They make the grass grow.
Is that so?
That's right. They run around all day, tugging and tugging at each tiny seedling. It grows into a great tall blade of grass.
Boy, that's amazing.
Oh, good grief.
And this thing
can't stand idly to listen to.
And way up there, the little stars and planets make the rain that falls in showers. And when it's cold and winter is upon us, the snow comes up just like the flowers.
Now, Lucy, I know that's wrong. Snow doesn't come up, it comes down.
After it comes up, the wind blows it around, so it looks like it's coming down. But actually, it comes up by the ground like grass. Snow comes up, Charlie Brown, snow comes up!
Oh, good grief!
Lucy, why is Charlie Brown banging his head against that tree?
To loosen the bark to make the tree grow faster. Clouds make the wind blow, bugs make the grass grow. So, there you go. These are little known facts that now you know.
Chuck, I don't understand love.
Oh, who does?
Explain love to me, Chuck.
Well, I can't explain love. I could recommend a book, or a painting, or a song, or a poem. But I just can't explain love.
Well, try, Chuck. Try to explain love.
Okay. Let's say... Alright, let's say I happen to see this cute little girl walk by, and I...
Why does she have to be cute? Can't someone fall in love with a girl who isn't cute and has freckles and a big nose? Explain that, Chuck.
Okay. Maybe you're right. Let's see. Say I happen to see this girl walk by who has a great big nose and...
I didn't say a great big nose, Chuck!
Not only can't you not explain love, can't even talk about it.
Well, there's something else that I'm sort of curious about. Do you think you'll ever get married?
Oh, I suppose so. Just about everybody does.
Well, what kind of girl do you think you'll marry?
Well, I'd always kind of hate to talk about it because I'm afraid it might sound silly. But I'd like the kind of girl who called me poor sweet baby.
Poor sweet baby?
Uh-huh. If I was feeling tired or depressed, she'd cuddle up right next to me. Kiss me on the cheek and whisper, poor sweet baby.
Sweet baby.
forget it. It'll never happen.
Do falling leaves make you sad?
Absolutely not. In fact, fall leaves are a good sign. It's when you see them jumping back on the trees that you're in trouble.
Did you see that falling leaf? This happens every year. This is known as one of the cycles in nature. There's a lesson to be learned from this. Do you know what it is?
No, but I'm sure you're gonna tell me, Sally Brown.
Girl dropped her pencil. It has teeth marks all over it. She nibbles her pencil. She's human. It hasn't been such a bad day after all. Happiness is finding a pencil.
It's always sausage.
Happiness.
Happiness is
having a sister,
sharing a sister.